The test report might be the least favorite topic for many penetration testers, but no doubt the most important thing to take care. It often uses 40% to 50% of a tester's time during a penetration test engagement. In this video, we'll show you how RidgeBot, the automated penetration testing, automatically generate an easy-to-read, sleek-to-show as well comprehensive and zero false positive security test report. This sample report is out of RidgeBot's test against two targets, a wasp's broken web, and Metasploitable 2. After the test is complete, you can choose to download the report in HTML, or PDF format, or preview it. Let's use PDF as an example. On the cover page, you'll see the title of the report, and the exact date and time of this test being done. Follow the cover page as the important first page, with the report navigation and the executive summary. On the top of the page, the number in this black bar is the ultimate zero false positive findings from this test. 21 critical exploited vulnerabilities, or we called 21 critical business risks later in the report, which means RidgeBot exploited these 21 vulnerabilities, just like a real hacker would do. These 21 risks are the very thing you should spend your efforts, as it shows you how a hacker would compromise your system. In HTML format, the quick links here takes you to each section by clicking it. You can see the report is comprised of 5 sections: executive summary, configuration at a glance, asset details, exploit details, and vulnerability details. In the executive summary, we'd like to highlight a few things. First of all, total health score, this is 100 scale score, indicates how good or bad your security posture is. The higher the number, the healthier the system. The targets in this test are well-known bad servers, designed by a WASP and Metasploit team with many vulnerabilities, therefore it appears very low health score as 1. Policy. Minimum score is the passing line set by Ridge Security based on past experience across industries. In this bubble chart, left-hand side number 21 as explained earlier, these are exploited vulnerabilities, and right-hand numbers show the vulnerability discoveries, they are categorized as high, medium, low. We also give the summary of total number of targets, active assets, domains and attack surfaces. This pie chart shows the exploits by type. You can see these are serious risks such as shell execution, credential access and database collection. In the configuration at a glance, we listed the key parameters configured for this test, which help you recall or understand the test circumstance, and this information is useful for future tests with configuration adjustment or comparisons among different sets of tests. In the asset details, we list vulnerabilities by asset. It's easy to identify the most impacted servers or domains. Followed asset details, there's exploit details where you can find the descriptions, affected nodes, references and solutions suggested. This is an example. The number 3 to 4 means the third and the fourth exploited vulnerability out of the total 21. In this exploit, RidgeBot obtained shell connection via command injection vulnerability, and it tells what happened and how it happened and, in the end, also gives solution as a mitigation suggestion. The vulnerability detail section gives details about all vulnerabilities found. It means to provide a security team a comprehensive view of vulnerabilities. With this newly designed report, you can present summarized key findings to your management team or auditing authorities, quickly focus on the zero false positive risks, and document all exploits and vulnerability details for further investigations. It greatly shortens the time to write a good audit report and gain your security team more insights, and make them much more productive.